Hi. My next guest is the first time on TBN in the Praise program, Dr. Peter Maloof. Welcome, my friend.
Thank you so much, Paul.
And Peter is actually a dermatologist from Fort Worth, Texas. Now, your specialty is you deal with skin all day long.
Correct.
Face, back, neck, the whole thing.
Everything.
Tell
yes.
me about that.
Well, I am a dermatologist and board-certified dermatologist and the founder of the Center for Skin and Cosmetic Dermatology in Fort Worth. And as you may know already, the skin is the largest organ in the body.
Mm-hmm.
And any skin disorder can be manifested from any disease you can think of.
Right.
Diabetes, hypertension, autoimmune diseases all can manifest themselves in the skin. So. There's no shortage of complaints in our patients who come to see us for those problems.
And a lot of times what you see on the skin is the first symptom or the first sign that there may be something deeper inside going on. Do you run into that quite a bit?
Most definitely. From cancer to infectious diseases to autoimmune diseases to common diseases such as diabetes and
yeah.
high blood pressure all can manifest themselves in the skin, and signs and symptoms are readily available in my profession as I get to see them
yeah.
instead of test for them and run diagnostic studies. I can often diagnose problems just by looking at the skin.
Yeah. What do we do wrong? How do we mistreat this temple or the covering of the temple, so to speak?
Well, the first thing that comes to mind is, things you can basically have control over, which are sun exposure is the big one, because I deal with skin cancer on a daily basis in the surgical realm. And
now, is a certain mm-hmm. amount of sun okay? Should we get some, too much? I mean, how does that work?
Well, I'm a little biased. I do agree, as Jordan mentioned, that you do need a certain amount of sunlight and warmth daily to convert vitamin D to its useful form
okay.
for bones. However, as you may be aware, most Americans take that to the nth degree and,
yeah.
and use that as a license to tan, which is highly affecting our outcomes of skin cancer.
Yeah. So laying in the sun, like in the natural sun, out by a pool, good, bad, indifferent, how do you feel about that?
Well, I believe it's bad. I think UV from any source uh-huh. In excess is directly linked to skin cancer.
Wow.
What
if you put oil on or something like that?
Well, that's even worse. I mean,
does it make it worse?
If you're going to amplify the effects of the sun, you're going to shorten your duration of time when you experience the effects of that, whether it's accelerated aging
yeah.
or skin cancer.
Yeah.
There are three forms of UV that reach are emitted from the sun. Only two of those reach the earth. That's UVA and UVB.
Okay.
And basically what ultraviolet light does is create little missiles in your skin that destroy the key elements of the skin, like the collagen, and also cause genetic mutation mutations in the cells that lead to skin cancer. And so that illustrates the importance of avoidance of the sun and protection while in the sun
yeah.
and choosing a sunscreen, for example.
And this is probably a dumb question, but tanning booths or tanning salons, is it like run, forest, run type of thing, just stay away?
That is my opinion, especially if you're fair-skinned and you're trying to talk yourself into believing that you can actually tan when, in fact, you turn lobster red.
Right.
Tanning booths emit ultraviolet light as well as the sun, and any form of UV is harmful to the skin and has been linked with all types of skin cancer.
Mm. How do we recognize skin cancer? What does it look like? What's the difference between a mole,
sure.
a blastoma, this or that? I mean, there's so many different things. What is skin cancer?
Well, there are hundreds, literally, of different types of cancers that can occur in the skin. However, we talk about the most common three. Basal cell carcinoma is the most common cancer known to man and the most common skin cancer.
Yeah.
And it's directly related to cumulative sun exposure. Squamous cell carcinoma is probably second on that list, and melanoma, the big feared cancer, which is potentially lethal.
Mm-hmm.
And how do you recognize it? Most commonly, a skin cancer presents as a non-healing area. When we're talking about basal cell, it's a pearly nodule or bump that occurs on the skin that does not recede and sometimes breaks down into a little bloody crust.
Hmm.
Squamous cell carcinoma is potentially deadly and presents similarly, although it has a more invasive characteristic. And then the melanoma is the so-called mole gone bad. When you see a brown spot that changes on your body, that should alert you to see your dermatologist for a biopsy to prove whether or not you're dealing with something potentially lethal like melanoma.
Yeah, and it can, and will kill you, right?
Melanoma is the deadly form of skin cancer, but if caught early, we can cure it with almost 100% accuracy. It's all about the depth, and that's why avoiding having your skin checked and can mean your life.
Okay, sun, UV, what else do we do to harm our skin?
Well, smoking is a big one. Smoking accelerates the effects of aging by irritating the skin and causing a breakdown of collagen, which is the structural framework of the skin.
Yeah.
When you damage the collagen, the texture, the color, the hue, the overall state of health is affected, of course, by smoking, not to mention its cancerous effects on the respiratory tract.
And that, to me, is such a no-brainer.
Right.
Because you see these people that have smoked 30 years, but they look 40 years older than they really are.
Exactly.
You know, these 40-year-old men or women that look 70.
Exactly.
And it's mostly because, what, does the smoke break the skin cells down?
It certainly does. It causes a chronic irritating effect of the skin cells and the collagen, as we mentioned there.
Yeah.
And it just does accelerate the effects of aging. That's why they appear older than they are. And also,
yeah,
the muscles that are used to smoke actually create these smoker's lines that you see around the mouth.
Right. Well, for those that maybe grew up in Southern California or in a sunny area, is there any way to reverse the effects of sun damage or some of the stuff that we've done over the years?
Well, to a small degree. The most important point there is to avoid the sun exposure. That's the only risk factor you can really change. You know, your genetics, your skin type being fair, you're going to be at greater risk for skin cancer. But there are things you can do to make your skin more healthy, and it does involve nutrition and hydration, both in the diet and what you can apply on your skin, for example. Vitamin C is a necessary component of what we call collagenesis, which is making new collagen.
Okay.
And there are many professional products available to use to apply to the skin to affect that process. And as many of the speakers before me who can speak to this much greater detail than I, with the nutritional
right
supplements and the hydration.
Right. Just some of the aftermarket or over-the-counter mm-hmm lotions, creams, good, bad, what's your take on
well,
that?
Well, as you know, there are many choices there, and my biggest caution to the consumer is if the claim is too big and too good to be true, it probably is. Basically,
okay,
products can do the following. The skin products, they can hydrate, they can lighten, which is the pigmentation that we see with aging and sun damage, and cause exfoliation. Continual exfoliation of the skin can lead to new collagen formation, releasing a new skin layer on the surface that
sure
visibly looks better and looks more healthy.
Right.
And that's about all you can expect from products. If they claim to lift and they claim to remove spider veins and they claim things that sound too good to be true, they probably are.
Gotcha.
Although they are, there are very many products that are useful as part of the daily regimen to improve the health and quality of the skin.
Because the skin, I mean, we exfoliate every day.
Correct.
I mean, you're actually shedding skin cells every second.
Correct.
And creating new ones.
Correct.
And that's a healthy part of the process.
Correct. And using professional topical agents that facilitate that process to a deeper level can speed that up and get us down to some newer skin that comes to the surface and is less pigmented, less worn, less weathered,
yeah,
and more healthy looking. And that's basically what that process
good
takes
oh
place.
My gosh, good word. I'm absorbing it all and my brain's about filled up to here now, so I got a little more room left. But good information, good
thank
word,
you.
And you're going to be back at the end of the program.
Yes.
We'll address a couple more things.
Great.
Dr. Peter Maloof, thank you, my friend.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.